So this is what we're gonna do. Next month, I have two women poets, Diana DeCesa Hernandez is reading on the 1st, and on the 15th, we're gonna have Nancy Mercado. And then June, we're dedicating to Puerto Rico. So we're just gonna keep rolling along. Like I said, David Henderson's in the audience, one of our featured poets in the fall, hopefully, so we'll see. Anyway, today, I'm proud to introduce our featured poet, our first featured poet, thank you so much, a good friend of mine. We know each other for many, many years, just through the movement, what we call the movement. This is what I want to say in the introduction to Mr. Felipe Luciano. Now, Felipe Luciano, first of all, is prior to the whole Young Lords thing, was one of the original last poets. And that in itself was a movement, and that in itself was something to be talked about. These cats get together, black and Puerto Rican, to recite and to write poetry, to African rhythms and jazz rhythms that were the beginnings of our talking about ourselves here, like that, in that context, in that style, with that bravado, with that kind of poetry. The other aspect that Felipe has done for is being the chairman of the Young Lords party here in New York City. That again is great work, because that brought social change to New York City, to the condition of the Puerto Ricans. Like an example, I always tell people, if you feel that you're discriminated against when you go to get an apartment, you can tell the landlord to go fuck himself. You say, listen, motherfucker, and do something about it. There was a time when that was an unreality. Even if you felt like you feel now, you felt, yeah, this guy discriminated against me. He put his ad in the paper today, and just this morning, you know what I'm saying? And he's saying the apartment's already taken. So those kind of, that privilege, is, and that's just the tip of the iceberg, because there's a lot of privileges that we assume as people of color, I'm speaking, that we just assume that they're there, but people got their heads broken, people died. There was a lot of, you know, struggle. Everything that happens is struggle. You know, so we did something. Our generation did something. And I don't like being called OG unless you mean oh God.
All right.
So, okay, we're not passe, we're very relevant. As you can see, that the times, although they be a changing, they always seem to be the same, except worse.
Yeah.
So anyway, without further ado, here's our poet for this evening, Mr. Felipe Luciano, a great poet.
This is the beginning of the village of East Harlem coming together for Renaissance purposes, as opposed to protest. I think that we have the possibility here of taking East Harlem and moving it into another direction. I believe in Renaissance, revival, and revolution. A note about Puerto Ricans. They will never let you forget who you were, ever. If you were a chubby kid at 10 and they called you Goldo, you are Goldo for the rest of your life. It doesn't freaking matter. If you were Flaco, thin, they will call you Flaco for the rest of your life. So, since I was in the Young Lords, people, that's what I am. If I punch somebody in the face at 4 in the morning in an after-hours club, they'll remember that. If I betrayed some woman's vow, betrayed my own actually, and hurt her, that will last. He did that. Get used to this in everybody. This is what we do. Ours is a verbal culture, it's a circular culture, and we continue to do that. So the only way we can break through that is by standing up to the bochincheros and telling them to go fuck themselves. The beginning of the Lord started right there. There's a depot there, a sanitation depot. And we took brooms from them and started sweeping the streets. The guy told me no, and I just pushed him. I didn't think it was a revolutionary act. I was so used to fighting in gangs. To me, that was no big thing. I just pushed it at him. And he was in shock that some Puerto Rican, especially a black Puerto Rican, told him, you must be out of trouble. Don't you ever, I mean, the way he spoke to me was so, remember folks, I had just come out of jail. So I was not having it. I'm a 5'7", black Puerto Rican with a tremendous insecurity complex. So he said, I remember to this day, we were walking up, we wanted to clean the blocks, we figured, since garbage was an issue to people, why don't we do something? I thought it was armed struggle. I wanted to go to the guns right away. And old people said, calm down. It's not the guns yet. We're not ready for that. Why don't you clean the streets for us, which we did. So I came in and asked for brooms. You know those thick bristle brooms they have? Because ours were made of nylon and they were, and the whatever bristles they had were wasted. And he said, get the fuck out of here.
What?
I'll never forget, get the fuck out of here. These brooms are not for you. And I said, we're going to bring them right back. He said, what don't you hear? What freaking don't you hear? Get out of here. At that point, I remembered every little gangster that had beat me up on the way to the pool, to Jefferson Pool.
Jefferson.
We grew up with Sicilians, so go figure. Get out of here, please, piece of garbage. When he said that, I pushed him. It was his nigga. Boom! I said, don't you ever talk to me that way again. And I said, no, don't stab him. Don't stab him.
Yeah.
So I walked in, took the brooms, and we walked out. Believe it or not, for Puerto Ricans, that was a revolutionary act. He couldn't believe it. You mean you are assaulting the city? I said, well, what do you think revolution is? It's a difficult thing. So we took the brooms. The rest is history. We cleaned up the blocks, and of course they didn't pick it up, and we ended up throwing it in the streets and stopped traffic, and eventually they did pick it up.